better than me, then you need to do a confession. You a mess. You were scary to me, but you wasn't even pathetic, a parent to me. Put dust on you, a cheetah, run up there, I'm airing the scene. I feel just like Vegeta Prince, and I'm an heir to the sea. I mean, for real. Test the driver's soft, so I don't need to grab the wheel. That's a lot on my chest, but it don't mean the man is stealing. Mean I'm walking with some money, man, I mean a couple mil. Think you need a mail. You ain't even eating while I'm feasting in the field. That's why I'm always cheesing, cause I feel like Uncle Phil. And all this loose thing, the freshman ain't half the man as well. Are you irresponsible without your money? I'm not. Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And nearly spin the block around just like the hand on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And nearly spin the block around just like the hand on the clock.
Just like the hand on the clock, I go back to bet when I'm doing numbers. All the mad that I'm driving the bus, so they threw me under. Heard they mad, they don't wanna bust, so they pull each other. Think that they're the winning team, go losing, then they choose another. And that's okay, cause I'm competing with me, not you. I live with blessings like I can't stop sneezing, not you.
I hate to break about me and myself, tattoo. I blow away the competition like a ball of hot soup. And there's no catch. I go and get the bag, and I'm not bringing it back. I'm like a down QB. I put the pain in the past. And if you ever had a problem, promise I didn't ask. So it's 444 in the car, my dash. Shake a pick, told them all you ain't first, you last. Little boy, that's facts. I'ma grow that cash to my money.
What?
Too much.
Minnesota standards, but then again, it is still summer. Either way, the AC is working just fine at U.S. Bank Stadium in the Twin Cities. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Green Bay Packers and the Minnesota Vikings. Turn on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
Thank you.
Now the first carry for Dalvin Cook. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31.
All right, Brad, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
They'll come up now, second and four from the 31. Give to Cook out of the gun. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards. And it'll bring up a third and two more.
Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instincts. Being able to diagnose run or pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play. Third and two, Darnold sliding out of the pocket.
Oh, shit.
Fullback Ham. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Well, they were in search of a short gain on third down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards.
And at the 44-yard line.
So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. On the ground, it's Cook. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays.
First down. First and 10 at the 32-yard line.
From the 32 now. Here's first and 10. Throwing quickly, Darnold. That's complete. Well, as a lineman, they are trained. You've got to stay close to home. If you're more than a yard downfield, they're going to toss that flag, and they did there.
What?
Now off the bootleg, Darnold. Couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. Steps away to his left. That's to Dalvin Cook, his running back.
Bullshit.
15 yards, and that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot, and they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved. Just as you said, they want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
And he will have his first down as he's able to get about three that time on third and inches. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs. He gets this one into the hands of Dalvin Cook. They'll get to him just inside the 15-yard line. And even after that fancy footwork we saw, good job defensively to recover.
At the 14-yard line.
Ball at the 14 for second and five. Coming right, this is Cook on the toss play. Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a third and four.
Third and four.
A shotgun snap for Darnold. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Za'Darius Smith, he's the culprit, and that is now his 13th sack of the season as his great year continues.
A 37-yard attempt.
Badgley able to knock this one through. Well, they didn't get in the end zone, but pretty good balance there on the opening drive between the run and the pass.
Yeah, I think that that's probably what they wanted to get accomplished right out of the gate. Throw the ball with success, run it, of course, to set the tone. So if we saw the offensive coordinator's play sheet, probably wrote himself a little note. Exactly what we wanted to do. Probed it early.
pass taken in about 4 yards deep.
The Packers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Loving the Packers now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Now the first carry for Darrington Evans. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
No gain on the play. Second and 10 at the 25-yard line.
On second down now. It's Evans, and he's going to get about 7 yards on that one, up to around the 33.
And after that type of a run, there's some talking going on down on the field, but it's not trash talking. The guy who just carried the ball, he's going back and telling his offensive line, great job, keep it up, and we'll break that one soon.
It's a gain of 16 and a first down for the green and gold. When you give up points on the opening drive, in this case a field goal, you'd hate to go three and out. They avoid that.
They do, and it's also walking that fine line mentally, too, as a coach, isn't it? Because you want to emphasize to your team exactly what you said. All right, we gave up a field goal. Let's go back and at least equal that, guys. But if we don't, you don't want them to feel like it's the end of the world, either. Nice that they were able to pick up the first down there, help them relax a little bit.
They'll run on first down with Evans. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop it right around the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I think sometimes when you're trying to get after the quarterback, maybe it's better to be lucky than great, because I think on that one, he's just trying to get upfield and rush the passer. Instead, the tackle for the loss landed right in his lap.
What the hell?
He forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
Side here in this first quarter. On third down, Love. That's complete to Darrington Evans.
Ah, I threw it to the wrong guy.
And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield.
Threw it to the wrong guy.
Only 2 yards, and it'll be a punt on their opening possession. On now is the Packers punter, as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. Possession goes over here on the punt. And the Vikings will be backed up deep to begin their drive as they take over first and 10. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And they will start this drive with just terrible field position, backed up inside their own five.
But we have seen teams be bold here and take shots, right? Sometimes you go max protection, make it a one receiver route, and take your shot downfield and see what happens. And occasionally, we've seen success occur.
3-0 after one on EA Sports.
Vikings 3, Packers nothing.
The play fake, and it's Darnold. That's caught by the tight end, Irv Smith Jr. And he's taken down, but able to get this up to the 20-yard line. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
10 at the 20-yard line.
To throw is Darnold. They'll roll him out right. And incomplete. He was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
I may be an analyst, but I'm also a fan. I love it when people take the big shots downfield, but he was under a lot of duress. And I think that forced the incompletion downfield. Didn't have a real good chance to find his target.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Faking the give, Darnold. He's going to air one out. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line.
At their own 30-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage.
And now off to the races down the right side. Touchdown, Packers.
Touchdown.
Darrington Evans. His 17th touchdown now on the season. And the Packers have taken the lead. And this is up and good to make it 7-3.
Makes the score Packers 7, Vikings 3.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Vikings now to start their next drive. And it's been very much a slow start for them. Three drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio.
Under a heavy rush and down he goes.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Another try after the first down sack. Darnold. It's caught on the right side and Smith. And out of bounds across the 15-yard line. That catch good for 5. It's third down. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
The Vikings on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This will be a tough third and 18. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. A ball for it, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 34.
So that's back-to-back drives where they're throwing an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination
with my guys.
Because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are. On second down, it's Evans. And he'll be taken down right around the 34 after picking up only a yard. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with 3rd and 9 looming.
Hold on.
On third down, Love. And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Amari Hooker. And he'll return it to the 24-yard line. This defense had 3 interceptions last week. They're on pace for more than that here.
Bye.
Do not adjust your set. This is not instant.
Right. Bye.
This is a defense that is locked in. They're essentially running the routes for the receivers and turning them to the receivers themselves, aren't they? I mean, it is amazing what I'm seeing because the reactions of those guys back on the back 7, phenomenal.
She hit? Oh, shit.
After the interception, here's Darnold. That'll be complete to Cook. It's a gain of 5, and it's a second down.
Now, that's the type of play that gives you a chance to win. Nothing forced downfield where you don't have a guy open. Swing it out to the back, maybe even check it down, whatever you want to call it. Gain of 5. You're just trying to get 4 on first down. They're ahead of the chains now.
On second down, Cook. And he'll get this down only to the 18. It'll only be a gain of 1 yard, and it sets up a 3rd down and 4 now. But keep in mind, if you're thinking of staying on the ground, this is a top 5 rush defense.
Yeah, but I don't think you shy away totally with the run. At least show them the hint of a run before you decide to throw the football.
Well, they were handed great starting field position on this drive, but now they face a 3rd and 4. And Darnold got the interception for the 3rd and 10. Picked off inside the 10. The 40. He's at the 30. 10.
Oh, we got plenty of fight, baby.
And into the end zone. It's a pick 6 and a Packer touchdown.
That was a nice catch, and not by the guy you thought it was going to be. How about the defender turning into an offensive player as soon as the ball hits his hands? Off he goes, off to the races.
So how's she doing, really?
And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game.
Makes the score Packers 14, Vikings 3.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6. And now the kick is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25.
Oatmeal?
Oat milk.
Goat's milk?
Oat milk.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, did it work? I thought that's what she said, dog.
The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And last time, decent field position through the pick 6. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. It's going to be better with the football on this position.
So last night didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Darnold from the gun. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's 2nd down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often miss time that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked it on his target. But he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
So now 3rd and 10, a big play to start the drive, but nothing since. Back to throw, Darnold. Complete. And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. 13 yards as the Vikings pick up the 1st down.
He was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
We've got a 14-3 ball game with 2 minutes left in the opening half.
Yes.
Yeah. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang at Orlando.
Digilent.
Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL.
Yeah.
Darnold completes it. And have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
Well, remember, they tried to give him the ball and let him run on the last play, but I think the light bulb went off in their play caller's mind, and this time they get it to him the more conventional way, and it's much more successful as well.
Darnold from the red zone now. This one brought in by Jefferson. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so.
10 yards on the pickup. It's second and inches. At the pack.
Out of the shotgun, here's Darnold. That is caught inside the 5. And the Vikings are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
Goal on the 5-yard line.
They'll run with Cook. And he'll get him a bit closer as he's down to the 2-yard line. That gets him 3 yards closer here as it brings up second and goal. So they've been in the red zone 3 times, and it's yielded just 3 points. Can they find the end? And he will score! Touchdown, Vikings! Dalvin Cook hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Vikings are able to make this a close game again.
Please, mate, would you?
And it's up and good.
14, Vikings.
Plays on the corner all the time.
The lead cut to just 4 as they kick it away and turn things over to their D. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
Brings up 2nd and 2 at the 33-yard line.
Love now on 2nd down. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's 3rd down.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go 3 and out here and give the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
And that will be incomplete.
That could be the stop this defense needed to get them back on track. They've been pretty well dissected by the offense here in the first half. After that possession, now they know that they can compete with this offense.
Some indecision on getting the punt team out there, and they're going to get a delay. And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves them back 5. On now is the Packers punter, as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time.
You want him to play like that, homeboy? I got you. Got you.
And good hustle here.
I can run one defense. You want to play stupid? No problem.
I love the flexibility of these punters. Their leg drive, able to get it way up in the air,
and that allows their punt team to get down there and down it inside the 10 because they've had some time.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And the ball backed way up, so thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the locker.
Give me that shit, bitch ass nigga. Bitch ass nigga.
So well into field goal range, all the way down to the 15 here.
At the 15-yard line.
So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. And his kick is right there. It's good. So how about the turn of events there at the end of the half?
This is one where you go charging into your locker room having collected 3 points you didn't expect to get. And you look across the field and you see guys kind of pointing fingers at each other like, dude, how'd you turn it over and make us give up three right there? And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Final shot before the break. Darnold rolling to his right. Oh, going for Jefferson. And this is caught. And he's in.
Look at this boy.
The final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
This nigga ran my play against
me. That done.
I didn't get the switch like I wanted to.
I
knew where he was going.
Right out of the pocket. You could just tell he was going to take a shot downfield. He had his eyes down there the whole way.
He certainly did. He wasn't taking off to go, right? When he was flushed from the pocket, a lot of times you see him eyes on track, ball and get tucked, and he takes off, becomes a running back. But as you noted, stayed alive as a passer, tremendous body control, and a pretty good arm there, too.
And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And the points, they have come fast and furious in this quarter.
You really don't want to be on the defensive side of the ball right now,
Because you're either thinking
my replacement may get an opportunity.
Your head better be on a swivel.
Totally. Or maybe I just need to get out of the game for a while because I just can't slow these guys down. They've got to figure out a way to disrupt these offenses. And typically, one guy makes a big play, and that can help change things.
They'll be looking for disruption on both sides right now. Well, the first play of the drive lost four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. Now whistles here, flag down. I think one of the Packer linemen was moving. And that false start penalty.
No, he's in cover four now.
Pause here, second down and long. Instead, it's just a gain of 10. Caught the defense off guard there a bit on second and long, but now you still have to deal with third and long.
Yeah, you do, but you feel pretty good about the last play, don't you? And maybe it gives you a little bit of confidence dialing up the next one, and maybe your team will believe in it when you...
And it's caught inside the 30! Touchdown, Packers! Rico Gafford!
Could have had him at X Factor, but I didn't play against the Vikings. The first time, missed the extra point. Oh, no, I did.
Well, that's a heck of a response to regain the lead.
Remember
after
we was going to play?
The game.
And they simmed it? Yeah, all I needed was 200 yards.
Because typically when teams tie the game up, it's a little bit of a, how would you say, you kind of take a step back and have to get yourself regrouped. They regrouped in a hurry, didn't they? They attacked back after they'd been tied.
And in a big way, that was a statement long touchdown.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. I mean, that's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
Second and 12. Darnold. That's incomplete. And nearly another pick. My goodness.
For Justin Jefferson.
Trying to decipher what's going on out there because I don't know if he's just getting bad reads. I don't know if the defense is confusing him. I don't know if he just has, you know, bad info and intel before he snaps the ball. But he's made some pretty bad decisions with the football lately.
Yeah, several bad decisions on the interceptions he's thrown in. Frankly, that should have been another pick right there.
I want to do that.
Catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down.
And the key number on that play, three. Third play of the drive, third down, spectacular catch, turns into a first down.
First down saves them from a three and out. They go play action here on first down. They'll buy some time right. And they got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. Chewing up big yardage, another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10, right at the 40. From the gun, it's a give to Cook. And he'll take this one down to the 36.
Dalvin Cook.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Well, the second down throw on target, and he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
First and 10 at the 29-yard line.
Left, and he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. They'll fake the handoff. Now Darnold.
Messed up.
And so close, he gets it to the one. Out of bounds right there. That's good for 28 yards.
First and goal at the 1-yard line.
They'll run for it with Cook. And he'll get in. Touchdown.
Seen it coming, too.
Dalvin Cook, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Vikings are an extra point away. Tying this thing up. And that will tie our game here in the third quarter.
That ties the game.
44 is 1 here.
So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. Saints ready to get their next drive underway. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. They'll start out here with the option
run. He didn't flip it.
He will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Brings up second and 11 at the 24-yard line.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Off the play fake, Love. It's complete to his running back, Evans. And he'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6.
Oh, I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big, but in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a third down.
Two in the game and now 11 on the year. And the Packers have moved out in front. So on third and medium, they dial up the pass and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those. In this case, they took a nice shot at the end zone and made it pay off.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely.
Since I said something, he ain't ran cover for it. He
absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball.
Yeah, well,
I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Of play action, Darnold, and he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. Not much there, only a yard.
And that's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing, but in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
Tracy, it's only one day.
Looking to throw again on second down. Darnold, Smith catches left side. And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's say he'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
50-yard line.
Midfield from 149 to the other 49, a gain of just 2.
To the 49-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8.
Second down and 8. And that's going to do it. Clock hits zeros. They're not going to get another playoff. Time has run out on this third quarter. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Sometimes I needed shit. Not the sneakers, but there was a 8 yards to go on second down. Now Darnold. He gets this one into the hands of Dalvin Cook. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to 3rd and 10. From the 50, it's Darnold. Continue to mount. He's thrown 5 picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran a wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Brings up 2nd and 4.
They'll go again here with Evans. And some room to maneuver. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
There he goes again. And did he get in? No. Down at the 1-yard line. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18.
No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball.
And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. A great effort there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Packers add on to their lead. That almost looked too easy, and I think thanks goes to the offensive line for making it look easy.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one. I'm not sure how much everyone understands the preparations that go into a game for an offensive line, because there's a reason that running backs and quarterbacks give them big gifts at the end of a season after a big year. The consistency and the continuity it takes to know each other and execute their blocks is pretty impressive.
So they will accept the penalty and move forward. Position for the Vikings as they have it 1st and 10 at the 41-yard line. They'll start by running the option away. And on the pitch, the ball's loose. This is going to be
I know that taking care of the football is something that's drummed into every guy who plays this position, no matter what, whether he's running it, in the pocket, out of the pocket. But it's almost surprising to me that there aren't more fumbles by that position because of the way that they get attacked on each and every play.
Yeah, well, he had the fumble last week. Now here's 2 weeks in a row with a fumble loss.
Concentration has got to be there, and he's got to understand how much time he has to take care of a play. And maybe his clock is off just a little bit.
And his throw's going to be incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
They work again from the 38 on second and 10. To throw again. Love. Pressure coming from the Vikings, and they get there and bring him down. Jayon Brown. He brought the pressure on the blitz, and he gets there for a loss of 12.
Third and long.
The Packers on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This will be third and forever. Love from the gun. Too great, and he goes down once more. Harold Landry, make that now 8 sacks for him on the season.
It has been a good game for them. They haven't been pressured very much today, but on back-to-back sacks, maybe the defense is starting to figure something out.
That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt, and the offense will come back out deep in their own territory.
Let's go old school there. That's absolutely a great coffin corner punt. Someone's put some time in working on that, hasn't it?
Seems like every year these guys get better and better. It's amazing how they can command that football through the air.
Yeah, they used to actually practice with hula hoops where they place them and try and put them there. Now a lot of guys use barrels on the sidelines to try and put the football in one.
Play action. It's Darnold. Throw left side complete. It's Smith. And he'll be out of bounds near the 30. In fact, right on the 30. An ideal beginning of the drive there as they'll get 20 and a first down.
At the 30-yard line.
No, I'm up.
A play fake as they set up to throw. And Cook has it left side. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. They get 14 there. First down Vikings. Clock management definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case. Down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
Back to back good plays. Have them on the move on first down. A play fake, and it's Darnold. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it, and it took the ball off course.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Crossing routes.
The play action fake, they'll look to throw. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
We just saw another example of really good defensive football, which has led to the cushion that they have in this game. Got to him once again, knocked him on the ground, forced an incompletion.
Yeah, they've set the tone. It's one thing to set the tone, another to come in here on the road and set the tone. On play action, they'll throw. And a quick shuffle pass here is complete. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. Not at all what they envisioned on third down. 3 yards in the wrong direction. Excellent field position. On first down, Evans. Trotty! Get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Darrington Evans. His second TD of the game and 18th of the year. And the Packers add 6 to their lead. And the lead now 3 touchdowns and 21 points.
This score, Packers 45, Vikings 24.
I could have swear today was freaking Saturday, dog. I mean, Thursday. been apart. Team on the field now as they will send no, this I thought away. Today was Thursday, dog. Swear to God.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Vikings take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And they unfortunately are staring at a mini losing streak developing, trailing here in the fourth quarter. This would be their third straight defeat. A first down throw, Darnold. And this will be incomplete. A physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. A shotgun snap for Darnold. They'll get this one to the Golden Domer, St. Brown. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
First and 10 at the 42-yard line.
Darnold from the gun. Complete. Jefferson the target. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
Brings up second and five.
Throwing again is Darnold, sliding out of the pocket. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. He was trying to find Justin Jefferson there, and it's third and five.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
St. Brown has got it. Now he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Give him 18 there and give the Vikings a first down.
First and 10 at the 36-yard line.
Faking the give, Darnold. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
On second and 10, Darnold, he finds his target, it's Schultz. And he'll get two or three out of that one, as that is going to take us to the two-minute warning. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. They face a third down now as they try to find a late score. Looking left side of him, he's got a man. That's Smith. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. And boy, is he close. Did he get there? No, they're going to say he's short of the line to gain. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't have mattered. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
And the ball comes out. Love lost it. They will fall on it, but look where they recovered it. That's a big loss.
A lot of bad news on that play for them, wasn't there? Lost the football, lost a lot of yardage. But I think the good news outweighs it. Able to retain possession. That was big for them.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. That one covers 29 yards. First down.
Packers.
Remember Jackson?
McKay.
That one looks like he'll throw here. That's into the hands of Gafford complete. Back-to-back catches now. That one for 16 and another first down. Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on